na lang kayo ka-excited na mag-perform ngayon sa harap ng mga Filipino fans? And mas ngayong itong tour namin sinto gaganapin, mas tumindi pa yung nararamdaman yung pressure or mas excited kayo? And the second question is, sino yung mga inaayin nyo na foreign rivals na tingin nyo mabibigat lang talaga kayo pag nakalapin? Tingin.
Good morning, Sir Robert. Ivan Shane Putin from the Daily Tribune. Sir, apart from ano po, apart from the competitions that will be held here in the Philippines, what's the Federation's plans then to, where will the Federation send these squash players po na may constant na high intensity competition po to ready themselves for LA?
Yeah, we participate in the PSA World Tour events abroad. So we're hosting now, but our players are out. On the average, we do about two international outings a month. But that's on the average. So you're looking at about 24 to 20. I mean, the biggest one we've done is 29 international outings a year. So, pretty much we're averaging, of course that tapered down all the way during COVID time, but if we remove the COVID year, yeah, we're averaging about two international events in a month, 24 I would say.
Coach Lowe, you said earlier that the LA Olympics will only have the singles match, so what are the adjustments that you have to teach for the rest of the national team that for the most of their careers, the doubles or the jumbo doubles?
Well, of course, everyone has different priorities. And an Olympic dream is unfortunately not for everyone. Not everyone can be Olympian. If it was that easy, then it wouldn't make such a big impact. So for the rest of the team, they still have, you know, goals they want to achieve that may or may not be the Olympics. So that puts the doubles, the SEA Games, the Asian Games, all these games still a top priority for a lot of athletes. Some players, their maximum potential could just be the Asian Games. And I know being number one in Asia sometimes is the best that they can be. And not everyone can be an Olympic champion. So for the Olympics, it is just singles. And of course, for some of the players, that would be their goal to get there. But for some players, they will not have the opportunity to play singles at that level. So doubles will still be their best option for, like I said, SEA Games and Asian Games.
Thank you.
Well,
are two other players, I think you were interrupted, you were talking about which foreign players you were wanting to face. And ikaw pare, you're talking about quarterfinals. Obviously, you're thinking of other players getting past. Do you see any mga yun? Are there local or are they foreign?
Yung first round ko po sa second tournament po is local player ng Philippines, which is si Angel. And ang next ko po na as a round of 16 po is si
the second one is
Shamil po or si Guedes.
Are there any foreign players that you like to match up with, like a dream match? Yeah.
Sorry,
dream match.
Hello,
top seed in the Challenger Series.
Sino
mo
kakalaban sa finals?
Number one is Brooke from Japan. So, and then there's one, I played her before. I won like 5 games. Brutal games. And with me from Malaysia. So those two are the ones that I'm looking forward to.
Go. Okay, Dad.
Yeah, just to add on that, we do have also the IF sanctioned events. So you're looking at the world, you know, world championships, world team championships, Asian championships as well, both individuals and team. So we do participate in all those. Are mainstay that we cannot do away with that. And then you also have the Southeast Asian Cup. And several events under Southeast Asia as well, which we always participate.
Okay, good morning to all. Gab Peras from Sports Corner PH. Yung mga players, sa labas na lang tayo mag-i-interview with regards to some questions. But I like to focus on sina Sir Bob and of course Coach Bewin. Kay Sir Bob muna. Sir Bob, it's been 10 months of the year. How do you see yung progress natin ng ating national squash players, lalo na namamayagpag po sila sa international scene, especially si Jamaica who just won the silver, no, sa India, no, and other players who have competed at the high level competitions niya para lang sa podium and of course sa pagtaas nga ng rankings, sir.
Well, right now Coach B has been with us since March of this year. So that's what, six, seven months already. We still have a long way to go. I've seen the progress, especially with the juniors, especially with Mac and with Jamaica. You know, we never thought that Mac could beat our number one player, who's been our number one since, you know, I became president, and way before that even. Robert Garcia. So although it went to best 3-1, it was 3-1.
Four sets.
Yeah, so four sets. So that's for me a progress right there. Makis has been improving. It's been I think our players now understand the game better the way compared to what it was before. And that's all thanks to Coach Weaver.
By the way, what's the status ngayon ni Robert Garcia? Kasi sa pagkakalam ko, he will be retiring this year after nitong championships.
Yeah, he took a 2-month stint. He took a coaching job in Korea and then felt that it wasn't for him and decided to come back. He basically asked if he could come back and join the team. I said yes, but you know, I was on an iffy there because I didn't know, I know he wanted to pursue coaching already. So,
yes.
And he is, yes. So he spoke to me again and he said he's got an offer to coach in China.
In Chengdu,
yeah. So, I supported him. He's now, you know, completing his papers. Obviously, at a better allowance or salary to what we're offering. And so, yeah, he'll be moving there. For how long, I have no idea right now. It's what, 6-month contract or yeah. But he's proven himself. He's still our number two in the last national championship. So if he wants to participate in the Southeast Asian Games, the Asian Games, he would just simply have to join the eliminations.
Okay, Coach Weaver, I have one more question later. Coach Weaver, how's the progress right now and the training preparations of the national squash players under your watch? and it's been quite a while since you took over the national head coaching position. What are the improvements so far under your stewardship?
Like Sir Bob was mentioning, I think for the players, the key thing is actually understanding the game a little bit more, tactical, how to play the game. Because I've actually spent a lot of time speaking to them about the game. I mean, at this level, these are players who train on a daily basis. Everybody can do the same thing. It's just how you put it together that makes a bigger difference. So teaching them a lot more about the game, of course, training is one thing, but understanding it, how to apply it, and I think I've seen some progress so far. I'm also traveling with the team a little bit when they go for tournaments. So I get to watch firsthand what happens and to be able to make changes as soon as we get back so that we can apply new things and test it out again, come back, redo the homework and see what else we need to work on. So I think that has been working out well.
And lastly, to Sir Bob, alam natin ang grassroots program na yun ng PSA ay namamayagpag sa ngayon with, of course, with the upcoming hosting of the World Squash Day Philippine Edition. So, kamusta na yung grassroots program natin? It seems na maraming mga bata ang nag-iinteresado na sumali nga sa squash. At of course, para mabago talaga yung perception ng tao na yung squash ay pangmasa na na sport, hindi na pang mayaman. Good morning.
Okay.
Yeah,
please answer.
Wait, what was your question? I didn't get that.
that your grassroots is growing, nurturing. So where is it headed?
Oh, okay. The grassroots development definitely is a section in the whole program of the PSA that I am pushing. Our players are not getting any younger. And you know, we have new recruits now. I mean, these guys have been playing since, well, Christopher has been playing since 8 years old. Jonathan is also from eight. We have a girl now that's 9 years old.
Lizeth Reyes, Carl Calillo, also part of the team.
Yeah, they're all part of the team. Carl has been there since together with Bear 8, but then he disappeared, and so he came back, but he's struggling. So he's already in the under 19, and then you have the son of Robert Garcia as well playing,
yes.
Who's 15 years old. So he's he didn't start at an early age. He started a couple of years ago only. So, but we need new blood, and we're out there. We're going to go out there to get them. We have the inflatable courts, which we're going to take to schools, to provinces, to malls, and just attract the kids to play squash. Now, especially now that it's an Olympic sport. Then you have the two courts in Ormoc City, and I'm looking at really dedicating a coach there. That will stay there for 2-3 months and then come back, and then when he comes back, we're sending another coach over. So there won't be any absences on our part, at least. It's something that's close to my heart, and I definitely want to grow the sport in the Philippines. There's no reason why we can't be the number one sport in the country.
All right.